and welcome to my channel. Today's video is going to be about the difference between Korean and Western makeup. And before we go, just want to let you guys know that this is just my interpretation of these makeups. Not every Westerners and Koreans wear the exact same kind of makeup. And without further ado, then keep on watching. So I already prep and prime my face with moisturizer, sunscreen, and primer. And we're just gonna go in with foundation. So we'll say this face is going to be Westerners and this face is going to be Korean. And for Westerners, their foundation is going to be the exact same skin tone as their skin tone, like the skin tone, but sometimes it's a little bit darker as they want more tan in the skin. I'm just gonna go in with my trusted NARS Sheer Glow Foundation. Actually, maybe I got tanner, so this is going to be Korean side because I don't want you guys to misunderstand. So this is going to be a Korean side and this is going to be American side. And let's see if I can find foundation that's have my color in it. I'm just gonna go in with this free sample from the Makeup Forever Professional Makeup Forever HD Foundation. And I'm going to try to go in with this 127. It's a little tanner. Yeah, it's probably the same color. I just have to open this package. Yep, this is my color. And then it's gonna be half using the same brush. Just gonna buff it in. And now we're gonna go in with brows, which have a lot of differences. I am going in with similar products. So for Korean one, I'm just gonna go in with this Anastasia Deep Brow Pomade, and for the Westerner one, I'm gonna go in with this Tarte Amazon and Clay. It's the same similar product, but because this one is already dry up, so it's gonna have a lighter effect on my brows. So we're going to get on with it. Brush it up and then get on with it. I'm gonna focus most of the product in the later half of my brows. So I'm gonna draw the desired shape first. Oh god, this is a lot of products. So when you use this product, just tap it really lightly because it's really, really pigmented and really, really strong. So I'm just gonna try to make the best out of it and try to brush it out. And we're right now gonna go in with this Korean style. So I'm gonna go in with my Anastasia Deep Brow Pomade and brush the hair up. I'm just gonna go in and draw the straight brow. And just concentrate most of the product at the end of the brows. As you can tell that there's a lot of unclean edges. So we're just gonna go in with concealer to clean up the edges, so the mess that we made with the Western eyes. I'm gonna go in with concealer. Use my finger. Just like draw the edge out. Okay. Now we're gonna go in with our eyeshadow. As I told you guys before last tutorial, I said that you don't necessarily need eyeshadow primer. You just have to use concealer and then set and put it on your eyelid and then set it with your powder, and that's good enough. So today I'm just gonna show you guys using concealer, and it's gonna be the same thing. Okay, and before it creases, just set it in with the powder. I'm gonna use my hourglass powder. Oh, all the product is gonna go, it's going to be linked down below, so just check it out if you're interested in what I used. Okay, so as for Korean eyes, I'm just gonna go in with this gold color in this Naked 2 palette and then just get on with it. Put it in the inner corner. It's softer and more natural. After I'm done with this, I'm just gonna go in with the pinkier tone in this Naked 2 palette, Chopper, and just next. So it's like creating a gradient. And then after that, to create a smoke effect, I'm gonna use Busted. I'm using the same brush in this one eye, because it's like I'm going within light to darker shade, so you don't really need to use new shade. And as you can tell that it's a little bit messy, so I'm just gonna go in with my fluffy brush and just blend it all out. So this is what it has so far. I'm just gonna go in with the second color that we use and just put it in the middle again. It's weird, this eyeshadow don't really work with a setting spray. So this is as intense as we can get. So, and then I'm gonna use the last shade that we use, Busted. It's gonna go in with under eyes. Oh, actually I'm gonna use the blue color that I used before and just go under eyes for the first half to meet the Busted in the middle. So this is going to be our Korean side, and now we're gonna move on to our Western side. All right, so this is our Western side. I am going in with a fluffy brush and going in with the transition shade in this palette, which is Tease, and just concentrate in the outer part of our crease first. So most of the product will be there. So now I am going in with a darker shade, which is Busted, and just concentrate in the lower part. And again, most of the product is gonna be outside. All right, so as you can see, there's a rough edges, and just use the fluffy brush that I used before. Just gonna go in and buff it out. I'm going in with this light color called Verb, and just put it in my lid so it has that pop-up color. Alright, and then we're gonna go in with this booty cloth for our inner corner. As you can see that there's a rough edges, so we're gonna go in with the first color we use, which is Tease, our transition shade. And again, concentrate most of the product outside and then draw it in. And I'm gonna go in with the Busted again and just put it in the under as well. And we're gonna go in with concealer. So concealer, the difference in Korean and Westerner. So for Korean, we're gonna use a color correcting concealer, which has a little bit of red undertone, so it can cancel out my dark circle. It's my problem area. Just dot it. And use my finger to blend it all out. Westerner, I'm going in with my lighter concealer because Westerner like to highlight using concealer, and then going in with my forehead, my nose, and then anywhere else you want to highlight. Highlighter, I'm just gonna go in with my hand and draw it out so I can clean out the edges at the same time too. My forehead to highlight it up, and then my nose and my chin. And then now we're gonna set it up with our powder. I'm using the same powder. Oh my god, I can't. The eyeliner for the Korean eyes is straight, so it elongated your eyes and make your eyes look more innocent, like a puppy. So let's just go in straight. And when I do eyeliner, I always go in at the end of the eye first. So if I mess up, I can clean it up. It's easier to clean up, so I just straight. And I let it dry because my eyes is hooded lid. So like if I open my eyes completely before it dried out, it's gonna transfer to the upper part of my lid. So let's just wait a bit, guys. Great things take time. And then I'll just look it up first and then see if I want to dry it out more. I think that's a little bit more. And now I'm gonna draw in the rest, very, very close to the my eye line. My Western eyes, I'm gonna go in with wing liners. So normally I'm just gonna look for like where I want it to be and flick my brush inward like this. So I know that this is gonna be where my eyeliner wing starts. So this is the difference. Since this is like a straight wing and then this is like straight line. And now I'm going in with the mascara, the same thing, curling up, and we're gonna show the difference in false lashes. All right, so as for our false lashes, for Korean eyes, it's gonna be more natural, and then for Western eyes, it's gonna be thicker band. And for glue, always use invisible glue when you're like starting out, because when you make mistake, then you can go back in and clean it up. Okay, so now my glue is, I think it's dry enough. I'm going in and just put it there. Right. So now the lashes, it's there. We're going in with the more dramatic one. The more dramatic one and the thicker band is harder to wear because it's just, a lot. It's just a lot to put on. The same thing, put on my glue and wait until it dries. So now my lashes is done. I just can tell that the American lashes is way more dramatic, and for West, for Korean one is less dramatic. I'm going in with the mascara again, so it will brush my fake and real lashes together. Brush them in. Now it's together. I'm going in with my bronzer and my Shiso. As for a Korean one, it's less obvious. So the way they contour is that they want to achieve the V face shape. Unlike Westerners, Western makeup, they like to create like a cheekbones. And I'm going in with this lighter shade. Then my bronzer, and it's gonna go in and find how can I make my face V. So this part needs to be gone, so I'm just gonna put it here. And then put it here. So it's V here. We don't need to look tan. That's not where we're here for the Korean. And then maybe my nose. Definitely my nose. I'm just gonna go in with, but we want to be less subtle, so it's going to be what it is. And then this needs to be gone too, and that's it. I think that's it for the Westerner, for the Korean shizo. And then for the Westerner, I'm going in with a darker shade. I'm going in with my Too Faced Milk Chocolate Soleil. It's smell taste like chocolate. I'm just gonna go and clear my cheekbones. Not necessarily contouring, but I'm just like to go in all over my face so it's tanned and pretty. It looks like I'm just come back from a vacation. And now we're done. Not done, but we're gonna go in with my trusted brush. And to contour my nose, just use the same bronzer and just go in. Use my brush to blend it out. So it looks like smoother, like I just have a natural nose. So now we're almost there, we're gonna go on with the blush. As for our Korean blush, we're gonna put on the apple of our cheeks, and then for Westerners, we're gonna go in with like outside more, outer part of your face. highlighter. We're gonna go in for Westerner. For Korean highlighter. We like to go in more natural, and this has a natural finish. Some nose, some mouth, similar, but just less intensity.
For my Western highlighter, I'm going in with my favorite Intense NARS highlighter, and I am going to use all these colors and put it on the top of my cheeks.
Yes. Alright, so a little bit. For Korean lipstick, they like to focus their lipstick product in the inner part of the lips. And then to create a more natural gradient, I'm gonna use my foundation brush and push it in like this and just focus on the outer part of my lips. And then for another Western part, I'm going in for the full lips because Westerners like to have a fuller lips while Koreans like to have a smaller lips. It's just a culture difference. So this is the finished look. I hope you guys enjoy it. Thank you for watching. And before we go, just want to let you guys know that there is no correct or wrong way to apply makeup. Just do whatever you feel, got more confidence in. Makeup is like art, there's no right or wrong way, and nobody needs to judge you for that. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel. I post video every Saturday and sometime Wednesday. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye!